Hi guys, welcome to Culture Report Daily News. My name is Rashina, and of course, to kickstart the headlines. News reaching us, Atiku's son tests positive for coronavirus. Brazil football clubs offer stadiums to fight coronavirus. And lastly, Harvey Weinstein has coronavirus. Rapist 68 tests positive and is put in isolation. Atiku's son tests positive for coronavirus. The presidential candidate of the People's Democratic Party, Atiku Abubakar, has announced that his son has tested positive for the coronavirus. He made this known via his verified Twitter handle on Sunday. "My son has tested positive to coronavirus," he tweeted. The Nigerian Center for Disease Control has been duly informed and he has been moved to Gwagalada Specialist Teaching Hospital in Abuja for treatment and management. Brazil's top football clubs are handing over their stadiums to health authorities to turn them into field hospitals and clinics to fight the coronavirus pandemic. With football in the country suspended until further notice, more than half the clubs in Brazil's league are giving up their stadiums as authorities in densely populated Sao Paulo and Rio de Janeiro are seeking to expand hospital capacity to deal with the crisis. Current South American champions Flamengo are giving control of their famous Maracana Stadium in Rio de Janeiro to health authorities, said club president Rodolfo. And lastly, Harvey Weinstein has coronavirus. He tested positive and is quarantined. Weinstein 68 is isolated at Wendy Correctional Facility in Western New York. The Shane producer told prison staff he believed he has the virus when he entered the state prison system last Wednesday from notorious Rikers Island. Weinstein is serving a 23-year sentence for rape and sexual assault. Following the news, accuser Magogoen wrote on Twitter, "Dear Harvey, in your darkest hour, repent, and in your lightest moment, set yourself free." Thank you very much for joining us. Of course, for more news and updates on demand, head on to www.popcentral.tv/culturereportdailynews. My name is Rashina, and thank you for joining us once again.